He said, look, this book is speaking in our favor. See, but you people are all against us. So I said, this is true, sir. I said, you see, sir, the Egyptians, you know, set hard tasks for your people. They enslaved you. A free people that went there, they enslaved you. So God Almighty is telling us that the Egyptians have been unjust to your people. But today, sir, I said, you see, you have usurped our lands. He says, Didat, how can you say that? Palestine belongs to us. So I said, how, sir? How, sir? How does Palestine belong to you? And he knew his Bible, so he started quoting from the book of Genesis, chapter 17, verse 8. He said, I will give unto thee and to thy seed after thee the land wherein thou art a stranger, all the land of Canaan, that's Palestine, for an everlasting possession, and I will be the God. God Almighty promised it to us. So I said, now, the prophecy is, I will give unto thee, means Abraham, and to thy seed after thee. I said, who is the seed of Abraham? She said, we, the Jews. I said, no doubt. You are the seed of Abraham, but are you the only seed? I says, you know, in the book of Genesis, the first book of your Torah, no less than 12 places, Ishmael, that's how they say it. Ishmael is described as the son and seed of Abraham, no less than 12 times. And as for Ishmael, thy son, and as for Ishmael, thy seed, says 12 princes shall he beget, and I will make him a great nation, because he is thy seed, no less than 12 times. So, I said, you see, sir, you know, you are the seed of Abraham, and the Arabs are also the seed of Abraham. Why can't you both live in peace and harmony as brothers? He says, Didat, you see, we had this country. You know, we possessed it under David and Solomon. So, they are entitled to it. She said, how did you get it, sir? See, you went, came out of Egypt, 12 tribes, united people, under Joshua, united people. And you go into a village, their village chieftain, you know, they call them kings, Palestinians. They also had the little chiefs. So, they went and knocked over one king, conquered him. There's only one little chieftain and another little chieftain. You knock them over and you took the land by force. I say, if that entitles you to that country because your forefathers, David and Solomon, had it, then we would be entitled to Spain. I says, you know, my forefathers ruled Spain for 800 years. 800 years, the Muslims, and we have there, go through there and see the monuments that my forefathers built. They're still there. If we had the power, can we go and reclaim Spain? I said, the Dutch, can they go back to Indonesia? I said, look, our forefathers ruled it for 300 years. The Portuguese, can they come back to Mozambique? They said, look, our forefathers ruled it for 500 years. Nonsense. See? So he must have shared it with the other Jewish managers in the firm. He said, the guys know something, you see. So while walking through one of the departments, clothing department, and manager of the clothing department, Mr. Baynard, another Jew, he calls me. I was wearing my white dust coat, furniture trade. He says, come here, need that. I said, yes, sir. He says, you know, you may drink some, Mr. Beer, I hear. But you know, you can't do that to me. He says, you know, as for Ishmael, Ishmael was a bastard. Look, this is how they, the brainwash program. As for Ishmael, Ishmael was a bastard, he says. So I said, all right, Mr. Baynard, tell me now. According to the religion of your religion, Judaism, which is better for a man to marry his own sister and beget child by her, or marry a bond woman, a slave woman, a negress, and beget child by such a woman? Which is better as a wife, your sister, the slave woman, according to your religion? He said, no, the slave woman is preferable. He said, very good. I'm quoting from Genesis chapter 20, verse 12. You can check it out. And Abimelech, the king of Gerar, sent and took Sarah. See, he goes there, and this Sarah was a beautiful Jewess. So he's asking Hazrat Ibrahim, alayhi salam, according to the Bible, say, this beautiful woman, what is she to you? So Hazrat Ibrahim, alayhi salam, according to the Bible, he spoke a lie. He said, she's my sister. So she's your sister, well, send her in to the Haram. So he had to send her in. And things went wrong that night, you know, and the fellow couldn't come right with Sarah. We don't know what happened.
But next morning, he's frustrated and he's calling Ibrahim, Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, and asking him, say, look, man, because of this woman, I had a sleepless night. Tell me, what is your connection with her? So he said, she's my wife. He said, why did you lie to me? And Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam says, according to Genesis chapter 20, verse 12, he said, and yet indeed, means without doubt, she is my sister. She is the daughter of my father, but not the daughter of my mother. It's a different mother, but it's the father's seed. And she became my wife. So she is Abraham's sister, seed coming from the same father. And you said, according to Judaism, according to eugenics, according to common sense, that the Negress was preferable. And you say Ishmael is a bastard because he's a child to Hagar, a slave woman. So I said, if Ishmael is a bastard, then Isaac is a greater bastard according to your standards. We dare not speak about the prophets of God, Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam. He was a prophet of God. Hazrat Ishaq alayhi salam was a prophet of God. But now you're arguing with the sick mentality. You got to get rid of the sickness. You got to give it to him with a sledgehammer.